As a man, have you been wondering why it's difficult for you to go a second round after orgasm? And you've been hearing that some men go two rounds, multiple rounds, or do you have a partner who has tried to make you go a second round, but it's just not working for you? Well, in today's video, I am going to be talking about the sexual refractory, also known as the refractory period, why it's difficult for some men to go again, and how you can increase your chances of going multiple rounds. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Nurse Sandra. I am a registered nurse, a registered midwife, BNSC, and this channel focuses on everything health. If you're just coming across my video for the first time, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on your post notification so that when I upload a new video, you'll be the first to get notified. With all that being said, let's dive straight into the video. I'm going to start by telling you what the sexual refractory or the refractory period is. The refractory period is the time it takes a man to recover or gain himself after an orgasm. That's just the time between orgasm and when you're ready to go another round. And at this point, you feel sexually fulfilled and relaxed. Your desire for sex dies off temporarily. And this is just what the refractory period is. Studies have shown that the refractory period is shorter for younger men, which usually takes about a few minutes to an hour for them to go another round. While for the older men, it might take about 12 to 24 hours for their body to be aroused for a second round. Everyone experiences this refractory period as the final phase in a four-part sexual response cycle, though it's different for everyone. So the first phase of the response cycle is the excitement phase. In this phase, this is when the man gets aroused from kissing, touching, and every other thing that happens before sexual intercourse. Then your heart rate begins to go up, you start breathing faster, there will be muscle tension, blood will start flowing to your genitals. That is when you see the penis erect. This is just what happened in the first phase. The second phase is the plateau phase. In this phase, everything that happened in the excitement phase begins to increase. Your penis becomes hardened and very sensitive. Your heart rate and blood pressure continues to increase. And the third phase is the orgasm phase. It is the shortest phase and it lasts for a few seconds. This is when the muscles begins to contract, followed by ejaculation. That is when the man releases the semen. And the fourth phase, which is the last phase in the response cycle, is the resolution phase. This is when your body gradually returns back to its normal functioning. All the tension you've carried from the excitement phase to the orgasm phase begins to calm down. That is when the penis returns back to its normal size. The refractory period I'm going to be talking about today is part of this resolution phase, which is the period a man needs to recover before going another round. So why does the sexual refractory or the refractory period happen? The theory behind this is that as a man ejaculates, you've emptied your sperm bank and your body needs time to replenish your sperm bank. So that is just what happened in between that time after your orgasm and when you're about to go again. Before I talk about how you can shorten your refractory period, that is how you can go multiple rounds after the first round, let's look at the things that can affect your refractory period and make it longer or shorter. The first one is hormonal balance. Several hormones play different roles during sexual intercourse. If you have a balanced hormone, your refractory period is likely going to be short. But when you have an imbalanced hormone, it can affect your refractory period and make it longer. Age is another thing that can affect your refractory period. Younger men can go a second round because their refractory period is short, which may take a few minutes to an hour. But as a man grows older, you may start to experience long refractory period, which can last from 12 to 24 hours or even a couple of days. The third one is your general health. Having a good or bad health can affect your refractory period. When you have illnesses such as diabetes, hypertension, your refractory period is likely going to be longer than a person who is healthy because your body would need extra amount of time for it to replenish all yards love. And also, medications can affect your refractory period. Ensure to know the side effects of your medications before you take them. Then your mental health can affect your refractory period. If you are someone that is anxious of sex, it can lengthen your refractory period. How you feel and respond to your partner can also affect your refractory period. Stress is another thing that can lengthen your refractory period as well as your sexual performance. I believe we now understand the things that can affect the refractory period to make it longer or shorter. Now let's look at how you can shorten your refractory period and go multiple rounds. Try as much as possible to manage your stress and anxiety. Work on your state of mind. When you manage your stress very well, your refractory period will be shorter. Then engage in exercises. Do a lot of cardiovascular exercises such as walking, running, cycling, jogging, and weightlifting. These are all good for your overall health as well as your penile health. So when you engage in exercises, it can help shorten your refractory period and help you go multiple rounds. Learn to manage and treat chronic illnesses such as diabetes, heart diseases, and any other chronic illness you have. They can affect your sexual performance as well as your refractory period. Also, don't forget that certain medications can affect your sexual refractory or your refractory period. So ensure to know the medications you're taking, know its side effect and how it works before you take them. How often you have sexual intercourse plays a great role when it comes to your refractory period. Remember, we said that the theory behind this is that your body needs time to replenish the sperm bank. So if you were having sex every day or every other day, you should limit it to at least once a week. Reduce your alcohol intake. Alcohol is an antidepressant, and also quit smoking. Smoking can damage the blood vessels in the penis. Imagine these blood vessels damaged and you're there lying down waiting for the penis to be erect so you can go again. It's going to be impossible because it will take a whole lot of time for blood to flow through the penis before it can be erect. So quit smoking. Smoking is one thing that can affect your refractory period, that can make it longer. Another thing that can help you shorten your refractory period is by eating a well-balanced diet with lots of fruits and vegetables, and also drink a lot of water. When you're healthy, your refractory period is definitely going to be short. Imagine you're sick and you just had one round of sex. You're definitely going to be very tired, and before your body would regain the energy and everything it has lost, it's going to take a couple of time. That is why you should be healthy. Maintain a healthy weight. This is very important. Maintaining a healthy weight will go a long way to help you shorten your refractory period. Another way to shorten your refractory period is by experimenting with erogenous zone. Those parts of your body that you know when your partner touches them, it will make you sexually aroused. That is the places you tell them to touch. You can also make your partner pull or pinch your ears, your nipples, your testicles, and any other sensitive parts of your body. So basically, these are the things that you can do that can help you shorten your refractory period. If you find this video helpful and informative, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel, like this video, and turn on your post notifications so that when I upload a new video, you will be the first to get notified. Thank you for being part of my community. I love you. See you in my next video. Bye.